Hello everybody and welcome to my online chess lesson. Today I prepare some interesting topic in chess. This is about calculation. To calculate a good sum variation, it's very important that you calculate this in the good way. And how you have to do this? First, of course, you have to make a lot of training and to get calculation skills. And it's important also visualizing skills. In the chess book, Chess Fundamentals from José Raúl Capablanca, he said, calculation by visualizing the future positions is what we count. We have to count many moves in our mind. And what is important that we know when we calculate some variation, we have first to ask ourselves some question. For example, what good moves are available in some position for us. For example, we have here some position and which moves are available and not which moves, which good moves. Then we have to make some candidate moves, 3, 4, 5 moves, and then to calculate, and then to said, okay, this move is better than other, and just to make some decision which one for us is the best. And also it's very important what are the best squares for our pieces, and to put pieces always on the best squares. Okay, here we have one position. This is position number one. White is on the move, and white play and win the game, but we have to calculate how to do this. Okay, first we can watch the position. White has king on b5. We cannot give some kind of checkmate so easy, but we always has to think that if we do some move like rook a6 or something like this, that black can play queen b4, give some check, and then we will do nothing. Then it means that we have to do some forcing moves. And how to do some forcing moves, then we have to think and to calculate the right moves. Okay, here for example, if white play knight b6, wants to play queen a8, this is some idea to give some checkmate, but black can play queen e8, check, after queen e8, rook e8, then white doesn't have anything and black is still okay. Also, there is some line if white play king to a6, but then this is not good because this rook is not protected and black can take this rook. And this is also not good, but what white has to do. And now our calculation skills has to tell us the best way. But we have to think about the best moves. Okay, you have little time, you can make pause and you can try to find the best variation for white. Okay, I will show you. Can go. The best move for white is rook to b6, check. This is some kind of also chess tactic, chess combination. Here is one longer combination, what we have to see in our mind. If king moves to a7 or something like this, maybe he will get checkmate here. If king moves, for example, king c8, this is also not good because white has queen b7 check here, then knight e5 check, and there is a pin he cannot take, he must go back, and then white can give some check with queen. Rook d7 is not possibly, he must go with king here, queen c7, king goes back, queen c6, king goes back, and then rook b7, and it will be in two moves, it will be checkmate. And then it means that after rook b6, only move for black is to take this rook on b7 with bishop. And then bishop b6, and now white is playing king a6. This move was idea for white, and now, because in the first position when we watch this, then black could take the rook here and to give the check, but now there is no check with queen, no check with rook. White wants to play queen b7 to give checkmate. How black can defend from queen b7? And this is important position now to see all variation. The king cannot escape. If king goes king c7, then just easy, queen b7 is checkmate. It means in this position queen cannot go to e7, only move is rook to d7. But after rook d7, now white play and win the game with excellent combinations. You can also stop the video if you want to find alone, and I will show you solution. It's so amazing move for white is queen a8. Queen sacrifice. First we sacrifice rook, then now we sacrifice queen. But if king goes to c7, we will take the queen and it will be winning for white. And black must take the queen. And now everything is going with a check. Knight b6, check. King must go to b8. Knight d7, check. King must go to c7. And knight takes queen. And now we can see that white has knight more. And very important, white has a pawn on b3. And because of this pawn, he will win the game. For example, f5 is just nothing. White can just play here and stop this pawn. King will take the pawn. And it will be winning for white. Maybe black can try something like this, but this is just nothing because white has the knight, and knight will help white to win the game. We just bring the knight near, and after this we play a7, f4, and then knight to c7, checkmate. This example is so amazing, but need some calculating skill to make this very good. Okay, we are going to the next one. Next one is this position, and here white to move. What do you think if you are white, what you can play with white? Also, you can make some candidate moves. But many people immediately they said, oh, I saw the solution. I know what I will play. But also, it's not easy. Yes, of course, in just one look on the position and you find solution. But you have to think, you have to be careful, because maybe something is wrong in your calculation. What is first, what is on your mind that white is playing and win the game? Yes, many players, and I give this example for to my students to try to find some solution to see how they are thinking. And so many chess players, not so strong chess players, but, or some young players, some kids, they said, yes, we find, we will take the knight, because they know that this is a pin, and later, first white take the rook, and then white will take the queen, and will stay with the rook more. But if you didn't calculate well, then it's not, they said, yes, yes, we calculate well. And okay, black takes and white takes the queen. But what is wrong in this position? Black is on the move, black play and win the game. And this is something wrong in the calculation. Queen g4 was not so good. Queen g4 was a very bad move, because if you play queen g4, you have to see g5, and this is a second move what maybe is not easy to find. After g5, now we can see that on another side, black has two pawns and he will try to promote one into the queen. Here, for example, pawn takes g4, then b3. And if here rook comes to h3, black can just easy play b2 and promote this pawn into the queen. But if white take to b3, then black will not take to b3, because rook h3, but black has move a3, rook h3, a2, and then black will promote this pawn to the queen. And because of this, we can see that move queen to g4, it's not so good, because you have to find all this in your mind to calculate and to find all these moves. And okay, we go back with the queen, and this solution is not good. But what to do? Okay, we can see that here is the pin. Pawn cannot take the knight because it's a pin, and maybe just easy go out from the pin, and now threat for white is to take to g4. Pawn takes g4, and black has to go with knight back, change the queen, and rook f5. And later rook will go back and take pawns on the queen side, and will play some kind of endgame. For example, here, if black is playing b3, white can take, maybe also white can play a3, and then try with rook to come back and to to attack and to win some pawns, but okay, white can also do something like this and this. And here is also some tricky position that white has to think what will do. Also, the move like rook h5 is not good because of g5. And this always you have to think about some tricky and some poison moves. And just here easy rook b5 and knight f6, rook b3. Okay, here white has to play, but white has completely winning position. And this was our second example, and we are going to the next one. Here, this position is also very interesting. Black has two pawns against bishop. It means that white is better here. Bishop is better than two pawns. And black queen and king, they are not so good. They are on this diagonal d3, h7, and it can be maybe some kind of pin, but also, of course, black is on the move. Black has to do something, and what to do? Black play and win the game, but now need to calculate good. You can to stop this video and then to try to find solution how to win with black. Okay, we can see. Black has option also rook e3 to make pin this queen and king, but we have to think about that white also has this move to make pin, queen and king. And because of this, position is so interesting. To calculate move by move, what to do with black pieces. Black is on the move. What is the best move here? Yes, of course, the best move for black here is to play rook e3 and to catch the queen, and black wants to win the queen. Here, idea for black is to take the queen, but also idea for black is to play queen h4 and then to give checkmate, because queen cannot change the queen because there is a pin, and this is a big problem for white. But of course white has move bishop d3, and it looks that white will win the game. Just black will win the queen, but white will also win the queen, and then white will have a rook more. But if you calculate good, then you have to see second move. In calculation, sometimes is not important so much first move. Second or third move is much important than first one. Then there is coming a point of all our calculation. And this you can do only if you have visualizing skills, and to get this skill you have to make training for calculating. You have on chess.com also some position you have to calculate, and to do a lot of position I think your calculation must be better and better. In the beginning, you just do this slowly, but later faster and faster. Here, black to move, black play and win. And black is doing amazing move, king h5. He's going out from this spin, but it's very interesting. If white win the queen, then it's amazing move g4, and white is in checkmate because queen cannot take. There is a pin on threat rank, and black win the game. Also here, if white, for example, play rook e2 to make, to move the rook, something like this, to make some square that king can escape here and to play rook and bishop against queen, but black has just g4, it's again checkmate. Or maybe in this position, if white give up the queen and just to play some position with two pieces against queen, but black has queen h4 and again it's checkmate. It means that in this position white king cannot escape from checkmate. There is also some solution to play bishop e2 to give check to black and try to escape, but black is playing g4, give contra check to white. He can just take with bishop and queen g4. It's just checkmate and white is in checkmate. Yes, it's very nice position like this one. How to calculate after this move and this move, but it's not important. First move is of course important, but now it's coming the hard move, what you have to see in your calculation. This is king h5. Also in the position, we will go to our first position. First position here. The first move, everything is has some point. First move, this one to make a block, and then king can go to a6, and now there is no any check, and after rook d7, but the point is this one move, and you have to see in your mind that all black pieces are going, it's like everything is going with a check. And of course this is very nice. I like this problem so much. And this one is good. And here it's interesting. This is some tricky position. What you will play, what is your calculation, but king g1 is the right answer, but queen g4, like many people think it's the best, this is just not good. If you have good calculation, you have to see in your mind that black has g5 and then that white will lose the game. Okay, I think you will like this position, and it's very important that you calculate good, that some variation with the four or five moves, just to find every move very good. And the second or third move has to be so strong and without mistake, but with time you will make your calculation skill better and better. Thank you for your patience, for your watching. See you next time. See you with my next video. Until this, bye bye.